Hello. In this video, we're going to look at how to validate the size of a file that you are allowing a user to upload. Specifically, what we're going to refer to is that field right there, the size field. There's a couple ways, other ways that you could do this. Just so you understand, one of the things you can do is set a property in the form. That's one way that it's like, so max file size. Sometimes you'll see that if you're looking at someone else's material. That's not real useful. It's not reliable. The other thing for you to understand is that the best way to enforce actual rules is to, it's in the PHP configurations. And I'm not getting into that because it doesn't make a real friendly video for this, but let's have a look at the code and I'll show you what I'm going to write PHP wise. So there's several ways to attack this problem, but basically we don't want to allow users to upload gigantic files. We need to be able to put a cap on that. Reject some files because they're too large. That's what the code looks like. So, as I said, we are going to be looking at that file super global, right? It's called image, like it's been called in the previous two videos, and size. And so, the other thing to understand is that that number is in bytes. So, 1 million of those is approximately a megabyte. So, this right here would be like 2.5 megabytes. If you wanted to have a 2 megabyte limit, it would be that. So, this is a bit better than the just specifying the property down in the form. What I mean by that is sometimes you'll see a form and they'll have a hidden field down here. It'll be max file size. This is a little bit better way to validate things. So you're looking at that field, making up a number here. That'd be 2 megs, right? If you want it to be about 5 megs, you'd make it 5 megs. Also, I do want to reiterate the idea that if you really want to enforce this, you need to set some properties in your configuration files, and I'm just not getting into that here. But so if the file is larger than 5 megs, I'm going to add something to my output saying the file is too large. I'm going to flip that flag to false, right? And remember what that means. When your flag gets flipped to false, that means that the insert's not going to happen because there was a problem. Otherwise, I'm going to say file size okay. So just small piece. In the last one, we looked for error codes. In this little if block, we're looking at the file size. This is not going to be very interesting, but when I refresh this, hopefully I get a new little file size okay message here because that's well under what we were looking for. Now in the next video, we're going to look at the file type. And so I will talk about a couple ways to look at that. And that will be the last step in the validation process. One of the things I mention a lot when I'm talking about uploading files is there's some heavy validation that has to happen because we're entering into a world of potentially problematic things when we allow people to upload files. So it's one more thing for us to check, and I'm going to cover that in the next video.